today we have to start with phase modulator fiber optic sensors. Phase modulator means it's a simple just you have to send the light signal in multimode fiber optic communication technology. Multimode fiber optic communication means it's a simple just you have to send the multiple light source, multiple light source in a single cable, it's in single fiber optic cable in different wavelength of your light. Different wavelength means just you have to send the light signal same frequency or same wavelength means you couldn't understand to get an exact output, so all the light sources are combined together, it should be collapsed, so you will not get an exact output. And the phase modulation, or some real time example, where is a phase modulation occur means, like if we take our three phase electricity system, it's like a R phase, Y phase and B phase. So each and every phase having 120 degree phase shift, so then only it will create a rotating magnetic field. So otherwise, it would not create a rotating magnetic field. So the motor and everything, any rotating machines, maybe didn't work. So you have to create the magnetic field in the same phase means. So there is no magnetic field created in inside the motor. So the motor will not run. So here the same concept also here. All the light source having same wavelength or same frequency means, so you couldn't get an exact output because all the light source, all the data can be collapsed. So then only you have to create some phase modulation. So the phase modulation depends on the properties of length of the fiber. I already yesterday explained, once again I will repeat that. The length of the fiber optic cable and the dimension of cable and the refractive index and index value of cable. So here the refractive index and index values are based on the it is affected by some external factor. But what are the external factor here appear means, maybe you have to erect the cable over the transmission means or over the communication cable means. Just you have to pull to pull, you have to connect, so just you have to pull the cable and tie the cable in a particular pole or a particular place. So you have to apply strain, that means pulling the cable. So at that time the internal core cable will be some amount will be deviated. That's the minimum only, it's not a maximum, And you have to erect the cable in underground means some external force can be applied in the ground surface, so the cable will fluctuate some few mm or few micro mm or minimum, So it is a constant value, just you have to neglect it, I have to mention that I will assume that the index profile remains constant with the environmental variation, Environmental mostly vary agadhu because it's a minimum force only applied in the cable surface, this you have to omit. So the remaining factors only affect the phase modulation, like length of the cable and the dimension of cable. So that is a factor to affect the phase modulation. And the physical length, I have already told that. And thermal expansion, maybe heat can be applied in the cable. This also like changes the cable size. Then only it will affect the phase modulation. And the refractive index varies with temperature, pressure, and longitudinal strain via photoelastic effect. I already told that. Just you have to apply the pressure in the longitudinal. Just you have to pull the cable. During the erection time of over the direction. And via photoelastic effect. So on waveguide dimension, this you have to apply the waveguide. Already in the first unit and second term, I think we have to discuss about the guiding mechanism. So the guiding mechanism is nothing but it will support your glass core, inside the cable. Okay, it is also applied by radial strain. Okay, the maybe or cable fabricated in the circular manner, with radial manner. The strain in a pressure in the field or longitudinal strain pressure may be applied in thermal expansion. Okay, just you have to apply the heat, or maybe you have to erect the cable in high temperature area. So during maybe summer condition, summer season, the temperature up to going to 45 degree, around 45 to 50 degree. So at the time the cable elasticity will increase. Okay. So at the time also the phase modulation can be changing. Okay. So next point, the phase change occurring in the fiber optic cable is detected by using optical fiber interferomagnetic techniques, and that convert phase modulation to intensity modulation. So these are all the factors to be affect the phase modulation. So how it can be find out? Okay, so we are using optical fiber interferomagnetic technique, and you have to convert the phase modulation into intensity modulation. So what all the intensity, maybe intensity means which amount of light intensity you have to apply, and what amount of light intensity you have to get outside. Okay, both input and output are same irundatha, just you have to get the exact output. So during the external factors, the phase modulation can be affected. So you will get a output not equal of your input. Okay, some distortion is there. Okay, so just you have to change or remove that particular one. You are using the technique intensity modulation. Okay, modulation, the intensity modulation technique. I have to show the diagram how it can be find out. Means here various techniques is there. Just you have to draw the one or two diagram, no problem. I have to put the four diagrams, Mach center and Fabry Perot, and it's a two types, and A and B classification. Here just see the diagram. There is a laser source, there is a coupling unit. Okay, and that means I have mentioned 3 dB. 3 dB means 3 dB. Okay, 3 dB light intensity we have to measure in decibel unit. Okay, coupler or splitter. Okay, coupler means you have to connect the laser into your fiber optic cable, and splitter means you will split the fiber optic cable into another our external device. So external device is a photo detector. Okay, it will detect the photo density. Okay, what amount of light intensity can be appeared here. Okay, so first one is sensor arm. So sensor arm is nothing but your reference, that means a sensing element, and opposite we have to put a reference arm. Reference arm means the direct light source can be directly connected to the reference arm and directly going to photodiode. Okay, and here that's a sensing element. Okay, in that area maybe any external pressure or something, any phase modulation technique can be appeared here. It will deviate the light. Okay, maybe you have to apply stress or strain or something, or maybe a pressure or like a temperature. Okay, any environmental condition, any physical quantity you have to apply it here. So at that time, here the output of light intensity can be varied. Okay, it is going to connect a photodiode. So the photodiode sends our reference signal as well as our measuring signal. Okay, say same concept of an intrinsic one. Okay, intrinsic also same. Here we have to apply it external, that's all. Okay, the intrinsic means we have to measure the light wavelength in inside of the cable. Here we have to using your sensor arm. It should be having a multiple like inductor. Okay, multiple turns to be wound in that particular element. Okay, so you have to apply pressure, temperature or any quantity. Okay, on the surface of your sensing element. Okay, so you have to apply pressure or maybe a temperature, means it will expand or it will affect the So it will some expand or maybe compress means it will compress. At that time, the internal light source will be affected. Okay, that affected or deviated light source can be connected to your photo detector, and the photo detector sends both reference signal and measuring signal and compare that how much amount of deviation is going there, and it will going to some electronic processor or something controller unit, and it can be calculated. The microprocessor microcontroller can calculate how much amount of phase deviation will occur. Okay, here another method. Okay, it is another type. We have to wound the coil in inductor type. Here we have to wound the coil in optical fiber coil. Okay, just you have to put a one round of coil. Okay, that is a laser instrument. It is going to wound the coil and get a photo detector. Okay, and here two photo detectors are placed here. Here only one photo detector placed here. Okay, you have to measure the laser source in previous. Okay, just you have to measure the reference signal here and get a output here, and you have to compare these two sources. Okay, so here you have to avoid one photodiode. Okay, there is a MAC center type of phase modulation identification or phase modulation technique, and Fabry-Perot technique is here. Just the same, a single laser or splitter or coupler is there, and laser source will directly applied here and going to some mirror, and it will replicate. Okay, just you have to put a mirror means the light source is striking here and reply to the same cable and going to here, or otherwise in the coupler unit you have to coupling two photo detector. Here you have to place the two photo detector. That two photo detectors are using to, first one is sensing the your reference actual signal. Okay, the coupler unit, I mean it is interconnected here. I have to put some circle here, so the laser source come here and going to photo detect and going to here and striking the particular place and get back to output. The same cable will get the light, so return light source here, it will going to another photodiode. Okay, so here I have to put a two photodiode, and first one is using for measuring the reference signal, and another one using for sensing element. Okay, the sensing element means just we have to it means half silver mirror. Okay, half silver mirror means the silver coating, that's coating can be placed back side of a silver mirror. One side is your actual glass and another side is your silver coating applied. Okay, then only it will reflect the light source. So here the sensing portion. Okay, just you have to apply the pressure or temperature plate here, it will affect. Okay, the light source can be affected here because our reference original light source can be striking here and return back. At that time you have to apply the pressure or maybe temperature in that particular sensing area, the light source can be deviated in another angle, it comes to here in coupling unit, it will connect to another photodiode. These photodiode have measure the reference signal or reference light source and measuring light source and find out the how much amount of phase difference or phase modulation take place here. It is another type. Okay, the same diagram can be explained in another way. Here the laser source here and the coupler and sensing arm and striking mirror. Okay, and it will go into another cable. Okay, just you have to return back to another cable. Okay, so the same mirror is striking here, it will go into another cable, fiber optic cable, and come to our photo cable. Here the same single cable can be utilized here. Okay, here two cables, okay, two fiber optic cables are available or connected, and it is to be connected here, and original reference signal measured here. Okay, and they were photo detector sensor, the displacement modulator light source, and compare that how much amount of modulation will take place. Okay, so this is the phase modulation technique. Okay, so phase modulation is a simple, your light source can be deviated. Okay, some angle, but maybe you have to apply it particular pressure temperature means it will deviate. Just you have to take one is reference, another one is deviated. Just you have to compare these two light source wavelength and how much amount of light can be deviated from original source. Based on that calculation, we have to measure how much amount phase modulation will be take place in the particular area. And next to topic is a displacement sensor. Displacement means how much amount of distance can be traveled, okay, by any device. Okay, just you have to find out the displacement of any machines or any object. Okay, what is the principle means? It is also extrinsic type of sensor. Okay, it is also an external. You have to apply to the signal in external manner. Okay, what is the principle means? The light source is sent through a transmitting fiber and is made to fall on the moving target. Okay, any object is moving in, thus you have to focus. Thus you have to focus the light source in the particular object. So the reflected light from the target is sensed by a detector. Okay, so just first you have to focus a light source on any moving object, and the light can be reflected. Okay, this light can be striking the object and it will be reflected. The reflected light source can be sensing by some using a detector. Okay, with respect to the intensity of light is reflected and the displacement of the target is measured. Okay, so first point is you have to apply the light source on moving object. Here displacement sensor, so you have to consider any moving object. You have to focus the light, and it is the light can be striking the moving object, and the particular amount of light can be reflected. Okay, that reflected light can be measured by using some detector or circuit, and that you have to compare how much amount of distance can be traveled. Okay, so first one strike பண்ணும்போது ஒரு பொசிஷன்ல இருக்கும், அது ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆகும்போது அதே டைரக்ஷனில் உங்களுக்கு ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆகாது. அந்த பர்டிகுலர் டைம் உங்களுக்கு என்ன ஆகும், ஆப்ஜெக்ட் மூவ் ஆகிருக்கும். ஸோ மூவ் ஆகும்போது பார்த்தீங்க அப்படின்னா ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் டிஸ்டன்ஸ்க்கு அப்புறம் தான் எனக்கு என்ன ஆகும், ரிசீவர் டிடெக்டர்ஸ் இருக்கிறது வந்து என்ன ஆகும், டிடெக்ட் பண்ணும். ஸோ அந்த பர்டிகுலர் செகண்ட்ஸ்க்குள்ள நீ எவ்வளோ டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ட்ராவல் ஆயிருக்கும் அப்படின்னு கேல்குலேட் பண்ணிங்க அப்படின்னா, அண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் யூ ஹவ் டு கேல்குலேட் பர் மினிட் ஆர் பர் அவர் ஆர் சம்திங். ஓகே, யூ ஹவ் டு கேல்குலேட் அண்ட் யூ ஹவ் டு ரீட் ஆட் ஆஃப் த டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் மீன். இட் கன்சிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் அ பண்டில் ஆஃப் டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர் இட்ஸ் கப்புள் டு த லேசர் சோர்ஸ். தட் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு கனெக்ட் த கேபிள் லேசர் ஃபைபர் டு கேபிள் டு த லேசர் சோர்ஸ் அண்ட் ரிசீவிங் தி ஃபைபர் கேபிள் அண்ட் பண்டில் ஆஃப் ரிசீவிங் ஃபைபர் கப்புள் டு த டிடெக்டர். ஓகே, ஸோ ஹியர் யூ ஹவ் டு கன்சிடர் டூ கேபிள்ஸ், ஒன் இஸ் டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர், அதர் ஒன் இஸ் ரிசீவிங் ஃபைபர். ஓகே, ஸோ டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர் இஸ் கனெக்டட் டு யுவர் லைட் சோர்ஸ். ஓகே, அண்ட் ரிசீவிங் ஃபைபர் கனெக்டட் டு டிடெக்டர் சர்க்கியூட். ஓகே, ஸோ த ஆக்சிஸ் ஆஃப் டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர் அண்ட் ரிசீவிங் ஃபைபர் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு த மூவிங் டார்கெட் கேன் பி அட்ஜஸ்டட் டு இன்க்ரீஸ் த சென்சிட்டிவிட்டி ஆஃப் த சென்சர். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஏதாவது சம் டவுட், இன் விச் ஆக்சிஸ் ஐ ஹாவ் டு பிளேஸ் த போத் ஃபைபர் ஆப்டிக் கேபிள், ஓகே, இது டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ரிசீவிங். ஸோ வேர் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த மூவிங் ஆப்ஜெக்ட், பிகாஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு திங்க் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் வெரி ஸ்மால் மீன் பிகாஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு புட் நியர் பை. ஓகே, பிகாஸ் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் வெரி ஹை ஆர் பிக் சைஸ் மீன்ஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு புட் அண்ட் சம் டிஸ்டன்ஸ். ஓகே, டஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு கேல்குலேட் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் தட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். ஓகே, ஐ ஹவ் டு மென்ஷன் கிளியர்லி ரிசீவிங் த ஃபைபர் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு மூவிங் டார்கெட் கேன் பி அட்ஜஸ்டட் டு இன்க்ரீஸ் த சென்சிட்டிவிட்டி ஆஃப் சென்சர். ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் வி ஹவ் டு அட்ஜஸ்ட், ஓகே, யூ ஹவ் டு கேலிப்ரேட். ஸோ இன் அவர் ஹேண்ட் ஒன்லி, ஓகே, ஜஸ்ட் யூ ஹவ் டு கேலிப்ரேட், யூ ஹவ் டு ஃபிக்ஸ் இட் அண்ட் தட் யூ ஹவ் டு கெட் அ எக்ஸாக்ட் அவுட். ஐ ஹவ் டு ஷோ த டயக்ராம். ஓகே, ஹியர் த லைட் சோர்ஸ். ஓகே, ஹியர் லைட் சோர்ஸ் மேபி ஆர் எல்இடி ஆர் லேசர் லைட் எனி திங். ஓகே, இட் இஸ் அ டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர், த லைட் சோர்ஸ் கேன் பி ஸ்ட்ரைக்கிங் யுவர் டிரான்ஸ்மிட்டிங் ஃபைபர் அண்ட் இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு யுவர் மூவிங் ஆப்ஜெக்ட். ஓகே, I think here I am moving object is very small. Okay, so I have to place the receiving fiber also, I have to put a nearby of transmitting fiber. So your object is large means you have to place some distance, okay, maybe 1 cm, 2 cm, some of them based on that because then only the sensitivity of fiber, the fiber optic sensor is should be a high. So that is a moving object. Okay, so the light source striking here, and that light can be reflected. Okay, so the light's falling on the object. That object will reflect the light. The reflected light will be collected through the receiving fiber and going to detector. So the detector circuit will detect how much amount of speed can be take place. Displacement is nothing but just you have to the object moving speed. Just you have to find out the speed of the object. Okay. So the light source will striking here during the moving time. It will reflect. The reflected light will be detected here. So based on that timing calculation, okay, I will send the time here and targeting here and receiving here. So based on the time calculation, we have to detect the light source, and it's going to microprocessor, and it will be already pre-programmed. Okay, so how much amount time take the light source is putting the going to the object, and how much amount to time taken for receiving the light source. Okay, based on the time period, we will find out the speed of the object. Okay. So working, when I told that the light from the source is transmitted through the transmitting fiber, and it is made to fall on the moving target. The light reflected from the target is made to pass through the receiving fiber, and the same is detected by the detector cell. And based on the intensity of light received, the displacement of target can be measured. Okay, if the received intensity is more, then we can say that target is moving towards the sensor, and the intensity is less, we can say that the target is moving away from the sensor. Okay, so the object on the nearby a sensor, maybe a light source nearby இருந்துச்சு அப்படின்னா, the light intensity is high. Okay, the receiving detector receiving the high intensity of light. That means the target is there. Target means the object is nearby the sensor. Okay, so apparently now light வந்து குயிக் அண்ட் மேக்ஸிமம் லைட் வந்து ரிஃப்ளெக்ட் ஆகி இட் வில் ரீச் த டிடெக்டர். மேபி தட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் மூவிங் டுவர்ட்ஸ் த யுவர் ஃபைபர் ஆப்டிக் சென்சர். ஓகே, மேபி இட்ஸ் கோயிங் டு some distance. Okay, the intensity of light will be less. Okay, the intensity of light will be less means, so the object is away from the sensor. So based on the intensity level is reduced or increased, based on that calculation we have to measure the how much amount of distance can be traveled. Okay, so it can be measured in few centimeters or up to minimum distance only. Okay, we cannot find out the maximum distance, it's not possible. Okay, this we have to find out the minimum distance up to 5 centimeter, 10 centimeter is possible. Okay, for example small objects are moving, or maybe some servo motors or some motors, and maybe some linear movement is take place in the particular area, critical area. At that place we have to place the particular fiber optic sensor. Okay, and without loss you get the exact output and calculate that how much amount of distance can be traveled by object with accurate manner. Okay, so because it's very simple construction and very less cost. Okay, less you have to only you need a light source and detector circuit and type of small fiber optic cable only. Okay, that's all. It's a minimum construction only. And you get an exact output compared to conventional measuring system. The accuracy of fiber optic sensor, fiber optic displacement sensor is very high. Okay, because you have to measure in the form of light source. Okay, so without loss we have to measure the exact distance of travel object. Okay, so it is very very easy and convenient compared to normal conventional method. And its applications. Okay, some few applications of maybe tumor cake. Okay, what all the application, right, the applications of fiber optic sensors means in general. Okay, so all the applications are general. Okay, so many applications are there, I have to list out few amount of applications here. Okay, so measurement of any physical property, physical quantity, like such as strain, displacement, temperature, and pressure, velocity, acceleration, in structure of any shape or size. Okay, so you have to measure the any physical quantity. Okay, it is possible, okay, using fiber optic techniques. And monitoring the physical health structure in real time. Okay, so monitoring the physical health structure. Okay, in the medical applications. Okay, in the medical applications, nowadays the technology is very high development. Okay, for example, in like US doctors can monitor the our Indian patient. Okay, through online. Okay. So how it is possible? Okay, they have to give instruction or monitor the patient conditions through online. Okay, so it is possible through maybe a wired connection. Okay, maybe using our data transmission in accurate data. Okay, thus see that particular measuring instrument. Okay, thus maybe a ECG or EEG or some testing instrument is there. Okay, so that instrument can take the exact value of the our physical our body, okay, and it will transmit the data to other person, okay, in other country. Okay, they are all available in other country. They have to transmit the exact data. They have to find out that so how much amount of effect is affected by the patient. Okay, they have to calculate the value and give a particular medicine or prescribed to that particular patient. Okay, it is a online, maybe I think telemetry is a technical name. I think it's a telemetry. That means the patient is available in one place, the doctors are placed in other place, so they have to monitor and give a suggestion and give a what all the medicines to give a particular patient. So everything to be monitored in a outside of that hospital. Okay, it is possible at that place. We have to using that fiber optic cable technology because it sends the exact value without loss. Okay, and another examples are buildings and bridges. Okay, and where it is used means concrete monitoring. Okay, concrete monitoring during setting time. Okay, so you have to build the construction means you have to put a concrete for a building and set the setting time, but the concrete will setting for it will take some time. Okay, so it will checking the setting time. Okay, how much amount of time take to setting and crack, maybe any crack is created, maybe that means crack means based on the length and propagation speed. Okay, crack monitoring, maybe after construction just you have to see the wall or the and roof, maybe sometime it will the crack will created. Okay, so maybe during the concrete time, okay, some air gap or air is inside the concrete means after few months or few years later the air will be releasing. Okay, through the hole or it will crack the concrete and the air will be releasing. Okay, so so that during the concrete time you have to put a exact calculation. Okay, concrete setting time or crack calculation, crack monitoring and pre stress monitoring. Okay, so pre stress monitoring, that means before going to put a concrete you have to calculate pre stress monitoring. And spatial displacement measurement and neutral axis evaluation and long term deformation monitoring and concrete steel interaction. I have to put a more example, just you have to write one or two examples. Okay, just you have to write buildings and bridges. Okay, it's enough. So what are the parameters to be measured in buildings and bridges means these are all the factors. Okay, to be measured by the concept of fiber optic sensors. Okay, and tunnels. Okay, multi-point optical extensometer and convergence monitoring, short cut and prefabricate value, walls evaluation and joints monitoring and damage detectants. Okay, so tunnels nowadays in India they have to create more tunnels for the transportation purpose. Okay, up to 1 kilometer, 5 kilometer to 6 kilometer. Okay, they have to create a tunnel in the hilly area and for the purpose of transportation. Okay, so you have to create the tunnel means you have to very difficulties is there during the creation of tunnels. Okay, so what are the factors means? So you have to go in inside the tunnel. Okay, the oxygen level is reduced. Okay, the light source is not available, and signal, the telephone signals, it's not available. Okay, so all the parameters. Okay, and also the volume of air is available in the tunnel is very minimum. So they have to set the vehicle speed, and this is the vehicle speed, and they have to put a create a way for oxygen inlet or air inlet or air outlet, and give a Wi-Fi signals to internal tunnels. Okay, they have to provide so various factors to cover that. So what are the factors here means? And I have to mention multi-point optical extension meters and convergent monitoring and short cut and prefabricated walls evaluation and joints monitoring or damage. So these are the mostly are civil terminologies. Okay, but we have to measure the these are all the factors measured by the our fiber optic sensors. And dam construction, foundation monitoring, that means foundation foundation strength. Okay, just you have to calculate the foundation strength, because in dam foundation is a very very important factor. Okay, the foundation is very loose means it is easily collapsed. Okay, and joint expansion monitoring, so you have to construct the dam with maybe with cement and stones or bricks. Okay, so various materials you have to using. Okay, and joint expansion. Okay, joining section means you have to put a shutter and concrete section. Okay, at the joining you have to check a pressure. Okay, the water will falling on that nearby shutter and the concrete section means in huge level of water can be stored means the shutter will withstand the particular amount of pressure. Okay, so at the joint expansion monitoring and spatial displacement measurement and leakage monitoring, where it is leakage is available, and distributed water measurement. Okay, so various factors to consider for application of fiber optic sensors. Okay, distributed temperature monitoring, maybe temperature monitoring during a summer condition, maybe the shutters are fabricated in the steel, maybe it will expand at least few mm or nanometer. Okay, some air gaps will be forming, the water will leakage. Okay, so every factor should be very important to measure the particular parameters. Very very important. So these are the basic application. Maybe asking 2 mark means just you have to write any 2 or 4. Okay, 2 to 4. Any doubt? Any doubt?